Hey everyone, it's Jordan. So last year I put out a video about redoing my front porch. I'll link to that if you haven't seen it. It's a very big learning experience for me, knowing pretty much nothing. I decided to redo my back porch as well. And the thing about the back porch is that it is way, way higher. I mean, this thing is like, I don't know, 20 feet in the air, or that's probably an exaggeration, but it's pretty darn high and it's scary. And there was nothing to stand on while we were redoing it. But the back porch was just really rotted. Again, a lot of carpenter bee holes, a lot of just rot everywhere. And initially I was just thinking of redoing the decking boards, but then I was like, what the heck? Let's just rip the whole thing out. So we made a trip to Home Depot, got all the wood, had it shipped here yet again. My neighbor helped me out big time again. And I think the craziest part was seeing him support the roof so we could take out everything below it. He anchored everything to the house and then sideways so it wouldn't buckle. I think that's what it's called.
But we're finding all sorts of uses for the old decking boards from the front yard. I mean, from the front porch, that is so long.
Once we had that done, it was time to demo everything, which I had to definitely be very, very careful about so I didn't fall and break my leg or something worse.
Good grief. Pretty crazy. Yesterday we took out this entire side and we put these that joist in and that joist in. We put this this support in right there.
So here's all the wood from up here, and it's just a huge pile, but I'm gonna have to move it to the burn pile back there. I'm not actually gonna burn it, I just need to move it.
All right, middle of the second day, go check out what it looks like.
Hey buddy.
We're getting our Christmas stuff out.
Should I just close my eyes and step out the door?
Terrible idea.
Well, that's interesting.
Look at all the decking boards already over there.
Oh my god, this is nuts.
All right, well, let's go in before Cleo jumps out. I'm getting a late start on doing more of the decking because I came down here and just cleaned everything up, cleaned up that wood, blew all this off, took all that out, and now we're pretty much just complete clean slate of nothing in the way, able to work safely. I felt like that was pretty important, and it took like 2 hours. Look at this massive pile of wood. I mean, this is both decks, front and back. It really is amazing to me. Day is this day four? You probably can't even see me.
I don't know. I can see you a little
bit. Don't step one more step. You will die. Here's the thing. Even though it sounds redundant and you feel stupid saying it, literally have to think of everything and you have to remind everybody all the time not to do something stupid. You know, right here you're able to step on this edge because they're screwed in. If I stepped on this edge right past this joist, you would die. If the boards would go and you're done. So yesterday, my neighbor, again, has come over and has been my saving grace during this entire project. Watch your step. And none of this is screwed down other than what I've done over there. It basically takes, I don't know, an hour every foot and a half of that decking because I'm screwing it in. Most people use a nail gun, which takes 2 hours to do this entire thing. But we're doing it the long way. The framing is completely done. It's incredible. This is so solid. I'm excited about it. And just look at this. Look at this. Look off. This is crazy. So I'm just gonna keep screwing this decking in. Just gonna keep doing it. and hopefully I get done sooner than I hope. It has been a crazy last couple of days. I haven't even like turned on the camera, but it's just been lots of decking, which is taking forever, forever. I'm not even done yet. I've got like, I don't know, 8 more boards to go, which is like four hours. And yesterday my neighbor has come over yet again and we put up this railing. And so today we're gonna do the rest of them. I think we have 2 more days of work and then we're done. The other night I was out here in the dark with lights for 3 hours, 30 degrees, just freezing. I felt like horrible the next day. Final screw. All done. I think this one is more crazy than the front porch. Like,
I think so too.
And it looks so nice because it's snowing.
The railings like literally would come off if you.
Oh yeah.
Them, so you could die.
Yeah, our dog now, knocked it off one time.
Yeah.
And almost plummeted to his death. That's when it was like, all right, let's get Eddie to come over and help us out here.
And then we have this great new table that Eddie built up.
Oh yeah, so this table was made from the decking boards.
Can you believe it?
That it, they were so junky, and now it's incredible. I mean, I don't even know. He's teaching me how to do this stuff. I'm just amazed at how it's done. Man, it's so exciting to see it, something that was so messed up, just be incredible again. It's a spiritual lesson there, Sarah. It's a very spiritual lesson.
I have learned so much since this entire project, like the front and back has been done. Like, I'm very confident with tools. I just pick stuff up really easily now when it comes to construction, basic construction, all right, it's like home stuff. I'm like more of a handyman, Sarah. I took apart our window and re-put it back together so I could clean it, and that's not something that I would have done before. The back deck has been a wild ride. It's been freezing, it's been extremely warm, and now it's snowing. But yeah, now it's just converted this entire area. It feels like a whole extra part to the house. I mean, I love being out here, and I loved being out here before. This is where I filmed my 5 a.m. video, which like blew up. So yeah, I'm very sentimental about the back porch. So I'm glad that it is up to standard. Again, just try stuff out yourself. It's very hard. You should probably get somebody who like kind of knows what they're doing, you know? Again, I could not have done this without my neighbor Eddie, who helped me the entire time. He's amazing. He actually has a woodworking Instagram page that we just got up for him, and he'd post on there all the time about stuff like this, like he actually posted about this, and I post a lot now about woodworking and stuff on my Instagram as well, so follow both of us, and yeah, you can see what we're doing. So, alright, I guess it's freezing. Bye.